Welcome to the new episode of Vande Mataram, the story of India's brave hearts. Born on 5th May 1911 in Chittagong, present-day Bangladesh, Prithilata Bhadedar was one of the first women who took up arms to participate in revolutionary activities. Her anger against the imperialist rule manifested in her at a young age. As she was influenced by the revolutionary literature, she read and was also witness to women taking an active part in nation's freedom struggle. While in college, she joined the Dipali Sangha, a revolutionary group that provided combat training to women and made them politically conscious. Later on, she moved to Calcutta for her higher education, graduated in philosophy from Kolkata's Bethune College, where she was a staunch member of Chhatri Sangha, Women's Students Association. While pursuing studies at the Bethune College, Calcutta, she came in close contact with Surya Sen. She was keen on joining his group, the Indian Revolutionary Army, IRA, Chittagong branch. However, it was not easy for her to find a place in this male-dominated organization, because of the general belief that women did not possess the necessary grit and fortitude needed in desperate situations. Prithilata and her comrade Kalpana Dutt had to undergo rigorous training to prove their abilities and commitment to the cause. After the Chittagong Armory Raid of April 1930, which was carried out by Surya Sen and his associates from IRA, the police clamped down heavily on them. Many were captured and sentenced, while the rest escaped and went underground. At times like this, when male leaders became prime suspect, the women leaders had to take charge, and Prithilata, who was inspired by the heroic exploits of the IRA, rose to the challenge and bravely carried out her duties. She was tasked with organizing women, gathering information from the imprisoned revolutionary in disguise, distributing revolutionary pamphlets, and collecting bomb cases secretly. She did all of this with precision while managing to evade the police very aptly. While still in hiding, plans to unleash attack were underway. In 1932, they decided to attack the Pahartali European Club, a social club for Europeans. This club was targeted primarily for its racial and discriminatory practices. It had a signboard that read, "Dogs and Indians not allowed." Prithilata, though only 21 years old, was made the leader of a group of 7 to 8 young men who were trained to carry out the siege. On the night of 23rd September, dressed like a man, she boldly led the attack. In the ensuing fierce battle, she got shot in the leg, which prevented her from escaping. Instead of surrendering, she chose to swallow a pill of cyanide and thus became a martyr. Prithilata sacrificed her life for the cause of the freedom of the nation. The zeal with which she carried out the assault and embraced martyrdom awakened the people, especially women. In choosing to end her life, she preferred a death of dignity to a life of degradation. Thank you. Namaskar.